Good day to you all. This video is about to show you something that I was asking myself if somebody else has experienced this. And that is namely when I add this bifiler choke over here in series with my output of the gate driver to the tank circuit. Then I higher my frequency or the resonant frequency of the same circuit as when it is connected directly. So to start off, this is the gate driver and it is going with this wire to this capacitor, and then we are going to the coil. So this is our tank circuit over here. So over here we have the signal generator, a current measurement, the battery that is the supplier of the voltage of the gate driver, and over there we have a power bank that is the power for the signal generator. And the transformer you see behind there is to protect, or is a safety transformer for the oscilloscope. So if I now put signal on there, and we looking at the figures, then we see over here that we have resonance at 1.2 megahertz. Now I will go higher in frequency. So you see it starts to drop down. So I'm going to a higher digit and I'm going to 2 megahertz. So nothing is changing. So I'm now going higher above that 2 megahertz. You can see there is almost no output. I will go to 2.5 megahertz. So as you can see, no output there. So when I now go back to my resonant point, and you're back going back to the 1 megahertz, and so we are coming back to the resonance. So 1.22 megahertz. Now in the next part, I'm going to add this choke in series. So I now placed this bifiler wound choke in series with the output of the gate driver and then going to the capacitor of the tank circuit. If we look now at the resonant frequency that we had before, we don't see any output on the oscilloscope. If I now go higher to 2 megahertz, you see that we have an output. Of course it is lower because, as you can see, we draw much less current because of the choking, but there is an output. And I will now change the setting so we can fine-tune. We'll go one digit higher. That's approximately the best output. So now you can see that we have resonance in the same tank circuit with no parts changed at 2.1 megahertz, only by adding this choke in front of it. Of course, because we draw less current, the output of the or the amplitude is much lower. But as you can see, we change the resonant frequency of this tank circuit in a positive way. And that's something I cannot explain at the moment. I also tried to how much current I need when this choke is not there and have the same output voltage. Maybe I can show you that also. It is not really good to just bridge it. The previous experiment that I personally did, I took it completely away, but we will bridge it in this way. And I'm now going back to the lower frequency of 1 MHz. Oh, and this time I forgot to look at the amplitude. Going back. So we have a maximum at this time around 104 volts and 45 milliamps. Okay. And in the previous experiment, there was not much difference in current draw when we go to the same voltage. So it doesn't act as a gain on what we are wanting. One moment, please. I'm going to fine tune. So you can see that we have approximately the same voltage and not much that milliamp difference. And as you can see, we have slightly less in this case. Now, for the low values, we must look out with measurements. But this is just to show you that we can higher the frequency of the same resonant tank circuit just by adding a choke. I would like to hear your experience, and maybe somebody can help me. What is the cause of this? Thank you for watching, and hope to see you in the next movie, video.